Welcome back, dear students. Now, in our third chapter, ascent of sap, we already discussed the definition of ascent of sap. Ascent of sap involves the upliftment of water and minerals from root to the shoot of the plant. Sap is nothing but the water along with the dissolved mineral nutrients. So this water and dissolved mineral nutrients are uplifted from the root and it reaches to the shoot tip of the plant. So the ascent of sap involves two main aspects: the path for ascent of sap and mechanism of ascent of sap. The xylem is the main tissue involved in the ascent of sap, or one can say that ascent of sap takes place through the xylem, because of which xylem is the water conducting tissue through which water and minerals are lifted up from root to the shoot of the plant. So there are two main aspects involved in the ascent of sap. The first one is the path for ascent of sap, and the second one is the mechanism of ascent of sap. If we see the path for the ascent of sap, it involves the water and minerals absorbed by the root hairs from soil and passes through epiblema or epidermis into the cortical cells. So the water that has been present in the soil along with the dissolved mineral nutrients are absorbed by the root hairs. From the root hair, root hair is a single celled. So from root hair, the water enters into the epiblema or epidermis. From epidermis, water enters into the cortical cells. From cortex, it reaches to the endodermis. From the endodermis, it moves into the pericycle through the passage cells and finally enters the xylem tissue. So through this xylem sand, water and minerals are uplifted to the shoot and reaches the leaves. So it explains the movement of water and minerals from root to leaves very clearly. This complete journey of water and minerals is described as the path of ascent of sap. Now we are going for the mechanism of ascent of sap. The mechanism of ascent of sap can be explained with the help of transpiration pool or cohesion tension theory. So the mechanism of ascent of sap explains how the ascent of sap, how the upliftment of water and minerals has been takes place from the root to the shoot of the plant. The answer of this question is a transpiration pool or cohesion tension theory. So this theory explains how the ascent of sap takes place in the plant. This theory was proposed by an Irish botanist Henry H. Dixon and a physicist John Jolly in 1894. Is variously known as Dixon and Jolly's theory of cohesion. It is also called as cohesion tension theory or transpiration pool theory. It is the only theory of ascent of sap which is widely accepted and fully supported by experimental evidences. It has sound basis and faced no objections at all. Many scientists have strongly supported and confirmed that ascent of sap in plants occurs through the mechanism of transpiration pool. So this theory explains the ascent of sap. There are following features of this theory. Water molecules have very strong mutual force of attraction, which is called as cohesive force. So this is the one of the property of the water molecule in liquid state, having the ability to cling to one another tenaciously. That phenomenon is called as the cohesion. So due to this mutual force of attraction, the water molecule forms a continuous flow inside the plant body. This force is very high, that is up to 350 atmosphere. Because of this, the water column will never break and remains unbreakable even when subjected to the disturbances. So water flows continuously if we pour water from one container to the other container, it forms a continuous flow because of this cohesive force, because of this strong mutual force of attraction between the water molecule. It forms a continuous water column inside the plant body and which remains unbreakable even subjected to the disturbances. Similarly, there is very strong force of attraction between water molecules and wall of xylem, which is known as adhesive force. So adhesion is another property of the water molecule. The water molecule having the ability to adhere firmly to the molecules of other substances like glass, clay, proteins, cellulose. So due to which it adhere firmly to the wall of the xylem. So there is a very strong force of attraction between water molecules and wall of xylem, which is known as adhesive force. So due to this phenomenon of adhesion, water column remains held in the lumen of capillaries. So if you see the structure of the xylem elements are made up of xylem vessels, xylem tracheids, xylem fibers and xylem parenchyma. So these are functioning as a capillary, and the empty space inside the capillary, I said it is the lumen of the capillary. So due to the phenomenon of adhesion, water column remains held in the lumen of the capillaries. Due to cohesion, water column in the xylem tissue remains intact and continuous from root tip to the shoot tip and mesophyll cells of the leaves. And due to the phenomenon of adhesion, the water column remains held in the lumen or empty space of the xylem vessels, xylem tracheids, xylem fibers. Okay. Next is there is a continuous and therefore very heavy water loss takes place through the stomata during transpiration. As you know, the transpiration, the loss of water in the form of vapors from the aerial part of the plant, mainly through the leaves, it is called as the transpiration. So stomata are the small pores or the openings that has been present on the surface of the leaves. So water escape into the outer atmosphere in the form of vapors through these stomata, which are present on the leaves. So transpiration involves the loss of water in the form of vapors from the aerial part of the plant. So by the phenomenon of transpiration, there is continuous and very heavy water loss takes place through the stomata. This loss of water creates a suction or a pulling force. It is known as transpiration pull. The value of transpiration pull force is very high. So this process of transpiration creates a thrust or a suction or a pulling force, which is known as the transpiration pull. The transpiration pull or retention created in the leaf is transmitted through the continuous water column to the root tip. Because of the property of water, that is the cohesion, due to which it forms a continuous water column from root tip to the shoot tip of the plant, the thrust, a pulling force or a transpiration pull or a tension that has been created in the leaf is transmitted through the continuous water column up to the root tips. This force of transpiration pull then uplift the water and minerals from root to the shoot continuously to any height of the plants. Thus, the water column in the xylem tissue is under tension due to the transpiration pull. So the thrust or a suction or a transpiration pull that has been created in the leaf is responsible for the upliftment of the water and minerals from root to the shoot continuously to any height of the plant. Because the value of this force developed is very high, from 20 to 200 atm, it indicates the ability of this force to cause the ascent of sap even in the tallest plant like the eucalyptus, which are more than 100 meters in height. This theory is mainly based on transpiration pool, cohesion and transmittance of tension. It is known as transpiration pull theory or cohesion tension theory. This theory is based on the phenomenon of transpiration pull, so it is called as transpiration pool theory. It is based on the cohesion and adhesion. It is also called as cohesion and adhesion theory. So this is about the transpiration pool theory. Now the evidences in support of transpiration pool theory. The osmotic pressure of mesophyll cells is more than 20 atmosphere, which indicates that it is quite sufficient for ascent of sap even in trees more than 200 meters tall. The osmotic pressure of mesophyll cell is more than 20 atmosphere, which is sufficient for the raising of water up to the 200 meters height. The process is purely physical one, which does not require metabolic energy, and even if energy is required, it is quite negligible. The tensile strength of the xylem sap is 25 to 300 atmosphere. This will be enough to avoid breaking water column. So water column in the xylem tissue is under tension. The tensile strength of the xylem sap is 25 to 300 atmosphere. So it forms a continuous water column from root to the shoot of the plant. The porous pot experiment confirms the ascent of sap takes place through the transpiration pool. So in this experiment, a porous pot is placed at the top of a continuous water column and the water is subjected to evaporation. If you see in the figure, a porous pot has been placed at the top of a continuous water column, and that water column has been put in a container that having water along with a mercury. The water column under tension does not break due to this cohesive property of water molecule. A similar kind of mechanism may exist in the plant. So through this porous pot, the water has been evaporated to the outer atmosphere. So this evaporated water creates a tension, a force. So this force sucks the water from this tube through the from the container through this tube. So this confirms the ascent of sap takes place through the transpiration pool. Next is the objections to transpiration pool theory. There are few objections to this theory, but all these have been overruled. The first objection to this theory: due to variation in temperature during day and night and large diameter of vessels, there are fair chances of entry of air bubbles in the water column. So during daytime there is a high temperature, during night time there is a low temperature. Furthermore, due to the large diameter of vessels, there are fair chances of entry of air bubbles in the water column. So due to the entry of air bubble in the water column, that water column get choke up due to the air bubble. But this objection doesn't stand true, as the water in the xylem is under tension. Any air bubble will be dissolved soon or will disappear quickly. The other explanation given for this is that as there are many xylem channels or conducting strands in the stem, the water continuity will be maintained by the side channels or the xylem strands, which later on assume the normal track. So any air bubble that has been formed in the water column is dissolved soon or will disappear quickly, or there are many xylem strands or channels that has been running side by side. If air bubble occur in one strand, the water continuity has been maintained by the side channel or the side xylem strand. So the air bubble which appear in one xylem strand, which later on assume the normal track. The next objection to the transpiration pool theory: it is said that under excessive tension, the xylem vessels are filled with a gas which is known as cavitation. It is similar like the first objection. The xylem vessels are filled with a gas which is known as cavitation. Milburn and Johnson in 1966 proposed that this problem will be solved as there are many columns of vessels running side by side. Blocking of one or the other will not hamper the ascent of sap, as there are many xylem strands or xylem channels that are running side by side. Blocking of one or the other by the cavitation will not hamper the ascent of sap. The cavitation is a temporary effect. It will be soon relieved when the rate of transpiration decreases at night. The gases in the xylem vessels will be dissolved and the continuity will be maintained immediately. So there are two explanation given to this objection of cavitation. So what is cavitation? The xylem vessels are filled with a gas which is known as cavitation. So cavitation is a temporary effect and it will be soon relieved when the rate of transpiration decreases during night time. The gases in the xylem vessels will be dissolved and the continuity will be maintained immediately. While the another one explanation is that there are many columns of the vessels running side by side and the blocking of one or the other will not hamper the ascent of sap. Thus, the overall discussion and the evidences in favor of transpiration pull theory indicate that it is the only satisfactory mechanism for the ascent of sap in plants. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.